Welcome to the journey of analyzing the deepest essence of price action. In the world of trading, every second counts, and understanding price movements is essential. With a standard candlestick, you have only the open, high, low, and close prices. While this candlestick indicates the OHLC values, it hides the real story of price action. As a result, you cannot analyze the exact tick-by-tick movement that constructed this candlestick. This insight is invaluable, because even if two bullish candlesticks share identical OHLC values, the price movement that created each can vary greatly. As shown in the image, two distinct tick data patterns can lead to the same candlestick, yet tell very different information about market momentum, volatility, and potential reversals. Having understood this issue, we developed the Tick Data Microscope product, which lets you uncover the full price trajectory within each candlestick, showing price data at levels as detailed as each tick, second, minute, volume, or range. Acting as a high-powered microscope for candlestick analysis, this indicator allows you to zoom into specific candles or a series of candles according to your preference, revealing the hidden patterns and internal price movements that form each bar. This high-resolution view offers insights to fully understand and interpret price action within every candlestick. Let's begin our journey to explore the deepest analysis of price action with Tick Data Microscope. Let's start by turning on the Tick Data Microscope indicator. You'll see the general section here, where you can adjust the settings. First, let's explore what this indicator offers, and then I'll explain how to use it. In the subpanel, the plots you see represent the price movement within each candle you've selected. These movements are drawn based on different bar types that you define. What's cool is that you can set the minimum value for these bar types, allowing the indicator to map out the price trajectory. Next, let's dive into the general section to see how these movements are configured. First, you'll notice the mode section. This parameter lets you set how the internal price movement within a candle is displayed. There are two modes, auto and manual. Auto is for real-time trading, while manual is used for backtesting, allowing you to check the internal movements of specific candles or groups of candles. Let us explain the manual mode first. With this setting, you can select individual candles or a series of candles to display their internal price movements. In manual mode, we need to use Region Highlight X to select the candle or series of candles where we want to display the price action trajectory. We'll go ahead and select these four candles for display. As you can see in the subpanel, four separate charts are now showing the internal price movements of the selected candles. When you move Region Highlight X, the trajectory charts in subpanel will shift accordingly with the candles in the selected area. You can also expand this region to display details of multiple candles. In auto mode, the indicator will display the price movement charts of the currently active candle or series of candles. When combined with the auto period parameter, you can adjust the number of candles for which you want to see the internal price action. With an auto period of 3, the indicator will display the trajectory within the current 3 candles. As you can see in the subpanel, the chart of the current candle moves as the price updates in real time. Next, let's dive into the data series type parameter. This setting lets you choose the type of time frame within each candle to display in the subpanel. In the default setting here, we're using tick data. But you can also view the internal price movement with volume, range, second, and minute bar types. For the volume bar type, the indicator will use volume chart data to map out the internal movement of the selected candle or series of candles. Similarly, with the range bar type, the indicator will use range chart data to display the price movement within the selected candles. Since each bar type is different, you'll notice the price movement in the subpanel changes accordingly. The movement of a 1-minute candle consists of several range bars, and each range bar will have different high, low, and close HLC prices. This is why the price movement displayed in the subpanel will consist of three different plots, representing three price levels. The blue plot shows close prices. The pink plot shows high prices. The green plot shows low prices. When you set it to seconds, it shows the price movement happening inside the candles based on the second time frame. Similar to the range bar type, the plots display the close, high, and low prices. Next, we have the minute bar type, where the indicator displays the price movement based on minute bar data that forms the current candle. With the 1-minute chart, you'll notice that the plots in the subpanel show only dots. We'll explain why that is in the next section. Let's try changing the main time frame to 5 minutes, and you'll see the subpanel display the price movement that forms the 5-minute candle, with plots similar to those for the range and second bar types. To explain this, we'll look at the data series value parameter. This parameter allows you to adjust the values for the time frame selected in the data series type. For instance, when using a 1-minute time frame, if we choose data series type as minute and data series value as 1, it will show the current candle itself with its close, high, and low levels. Going back to the earlier example, with data series value set to 1 and data series type as tick, the subpanel will display the price movements formed by one tick that make up the candle. Now, if we change the data series value to 2, you'll see the subpanel update its layout, showing plots for the close, high, and low levels of smaller candles that form the candle being analyzed on the 1-minute chart, with each small candle representing 2 ticks. Similarly, for other data series types, you can adjust the type and value of the internal price movements for the candles you're examining. Just a note, the time frame of the internal candle movements must be smaller than the time frame of the candle you're analyzing. Now let's explore how to use this indicator. With the mode set to auto and the data series at 2, we'll show you what this indicator can reveal. On the chart, you can see a support area here, and when the price returned to this zone, it reacted and bounced back. However, the price eventually broke through the support level, and we're left wondering whether this breakout is genuine or not. But by looking at the internal price movements within the breaking candle, you'll notice a segment of the movement that has a horizontal structure, followed by a downward movement. This structure of the internal price movements within the breaking candle supports a bearish trend. Therefore, this breakout candle can help us assess whether the breakout is genuine. You can also enter the market when you see the internal movement aligning with a bearish trend, without needing to wait for the candle to close. After the price drops and returns to test the previously broken support area, let's take a look at this red candle. You can see that it continues to form a distribution structure in the two current candles as it approaches this area. The price movement then breaks through this distribution structure to move downward. This further confirms that the breakout of resistance isn't a market trap, so you can consider entering the market at this point. Now let's explore the manual mode and see how it can benefit us. You can use this mode to backtest the market during significant volatility at key moments. Let's take a closer look to see if there are any signals during strong market downturns that we can use to take advantage of opportunities to enter the market at those times. In the subpanel, you can see a gap here, but you might not recognize this with the active candle since the price is fluctuating rapidly during these periods. Just a heads up, gaps are important support and resistance zones. Then the price breaks through this gap. At this point, there are two scenarios. 1. If you're holding a buy position, you might realize that this could be a bull trap, and recognizing this allows you to exit your position quickly. 2. If you're holding a sell position, you can consider increasing your trade size to take advantage of the market opportunity. You can leverage even the smallest fluctuations to make decisions without waiting for the candle to close during times of significant market volatility. Not only does this indicator help you assess the market during high volatility, but you can also use it to review signals from other indicators you're currently using. Now I'll be using the Imbalance Profile LiDAR Indicator from Ninza.co. Let's see how the Tick Data Microscope helps you discover more about the Imbalance Profile LiDAR signal. We'll check the IPL signal and whether the price trajectory from this signal candle provides a bullish movement. Here, we have an accumulation zone in the trajectory. Then the price breaks through this accumulation trajectory and moves upward. This means you can use Tick Data Microscope to dig deeper into the nature of the price action within a signal candle, enhancing the reliability of the signals from your indicator and filtering out any false signals. Let's take a look at how combining this Tick Data Microscope with another indicator works in practice. We're using the FIBA scalping indicator, which provides scalping signals. We'll use Tick Data Microscope to filter out any noise from these signals, in auto mode with the period set to 1. We have a reversal candle here. In the sub-panel, we can see the trajectory of the current candle, which shows certain characteristics forming a signal from the 5-bar scalping indicator. We've identified this as a potential 5-bar signal candle. For more details, feel free to check out the 5-bar scalping indicator at renkokings.com. Inside this current candle, we can observe a double bottom pattern forming in the trajectory. Therefore, it could be a good opportunity to enter the market when this pattern appears. That wraps up our look at the Tick Data Microscope Indicator. If you enjoyed the video or found it useful, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss out on future updates. Until next time, happy trading!